We had this report last time by the IEA, which I have to say made for very uncomfortable and you know, shocking reading, saying that revenue from Russia, from oil, increased 50% since the start of the year. What does it mean in terms of then the West trying to hurt them with oil embargoes? Yeah.
So thank you. It's a great pleasure to see you again, Francine. So it is the fact that we have not yet reduced the imports from Russia as the rest of the world. We have seen a bit in US, Canada, UK, but they are not the major importers. Okay. Since the oil prices are very high, it meant that the Russia in the first 4 months of this year, their oil revenues increased by 50%.
So Fatih, so it's not basically, you know, other nations stepping in and buying the oil. How easy or how difficult is it for Russia to redistribute, right, things that used to come to Europe and go to Asian countries, India and China?
Yeah. So first of all, Europe still buys, imports substantial amount of oil from Russia. But if Europe, as they discuss now, decides to stop import of oil from Russia, Russia has to, if they are able to, send the oil to China, India, and other countries. But it's not so easy. First, it takes only less than a week to send from Russia to Europe the oil. Mm-hmm. It will take almost 2 months by ships to send it to Asia. This is number one. Number two, you need ships, you need insurance to send the oil to Asia. Mm-hmm. And most of those companies are in the hands of the Western countries. It is the European countries. It is the U.S. And others, if they decide to take some measures to stop that, they can also do that. But what I'm seeing is, France, in general, we are seeing a reorientation of the international energy trade around the world, and it will continue more and more, not only for oil, but natural gas and the others. We will see more of that.
Europe is discussing a full-on embargo on Russian oil. How disruptive would that be for markets?
I think, first of all, we have to think, we have to see that there is a major humanitarian crisis happening there in Ukraine, and we have to respond to that. The world has to respond to that. It shouldn't be left unpunished. This is one. And the second, if we reduce the Europe, reduces the oil imports from Russia, it will not be easy for the global oil markets, for sure. There will be more volatility, but it has to be done. Yeah. It has to be done. And our job is to minimize that volatility, to minimize those risks.
But Fatih, how much volatility could we see? So could we see prices to 140, 150 this very
summer,
quickly?
This summer will be difficult. This summer will be difficult because in summer, as we know, the oil demand normally goes up with the driving season. And the production growth set to come from US, Brazil, Canada, still on its way, but they may not be ready by summer. The only issue that we have to keep an eye on is whether or not China demand will be still flat or very weak as a result of the Chinese economic weakness.
I know you hate talking about prices, but I'll press you on prices because you know, this could tip us into a recession. Yeah. How high could the price of oil go?
I think it is already very high, I should say, and it is for everybody in the global energy markets, every player who says that they are responsible players to make a positive contribution here. If you don't make a positive contribution here, we may see prices even going higher, being much more volatile, and becoming a major risk for recession for the global economy.
Fatih, when you look at the fact that Europe has not really talked about gas embargo, is it even possible?
It is possible to reduce the Russian gas to Europe, but to be very frank, from one day to another, to cut the entire Russian gas would be extremely, extremely challenging. But there are plans in place to reduce it substantially by replacing it by LNG.
For 5 years? How long
does
it take?
It is year by year if you go down. It is with LNG. renewables, in some countries, nuclear power, energy efficiency. We are, the Europe is going to reduce the Russian gas because Russia lost entire credibility as a reliable energy partner in Europe and elsewhere.